also helps to bring pelvic floor in a really horizontal position, and then it could contract the wall better. So the position is bend your knees, four, lifting up, both arms. This is the position. The feet are facing the ceiling. Just right to the belly, which is down. Breathe in here. Breathe in. Push up. Increase the internal. Breathe out. Relax. This done. Very good. So, and now you will try to feel that you want to breathe into the pelvis. Expand the lower body and also the pelvis. Breathe in. So, even the approximation from the... I'm creating here more arch. Approximate from the arch to his hip. So it will automatically activate better. You feel it?
Mm-hmm.
It's much more easy for him now to get the pressure, more caudal, to create more work. Yeah, perfect. And that's what I see. Now I feel he is able to expand the belly also above the groin. This is where I'm expecting the pressure. And the guided is what? Breathe in, expand. And when you breathe in, maximally, you hold the breath and activate the pelvic floor and try to unload a little bit the sacrum. But the sacrum should not go in a horizontal. The movement is supposed to be only like the feet are going very good towards the ceiling. You feel the pelvic floor going in. Yeah. So you breathe in, pressurize, and now activate the pelvic floor and go a little bit, only a little bit. Very good. Breathe in and go low. So if I give him the guiding from here, I'm just also
makes it easy for me.
Yeah, yeah. Because I will give you the direction where you are lifting your legs up. Yeah. Very good. So this is also very good drill for the lower belly and pelvic floor. Pelvic floor is supposed to be activated against the pressure. This is where how we using the concentric iron. When I cough, when I suddenly increase the pressure, I need my pelvic floor to have a good function.